we live at an incredible point in human history, don't we? I can't imagine anyone has experienced something of this magnitude in a long time. Some people were sort of saying this is like the worst thing since the World War, you know, which is a little bit crazy. It can seem a little bit scary, but what's really important is that we remember, despite we might feel these feelings of fear, nervousness or anxiety, to remember what God says about this stuff. You know, in 1 Peter 5 verse 7, we see Peter saying, actually, cast all your anxieties on him because he cares for you. You know, he gives a reasoning for that as well, and saying, actually, this is because of this, because he cares for you. You know you can trust him, so why wouldn't you? You know, be anxious about nothing. You know, that's what God calls us to do. Speaking of which, the verse Philippians 4, verses 6 to 7, I'm hoping you've got your Bibles and reading along. If not, pause the video. Go get your Bible. I'm guessing you've got your Bible now. And let's go to Philippians 4, verses 6 to 7, where it says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus." You know, so again, we see the promises of God leaking out of the Bible here, don't we? You know, not just the command to do not be anxious or anything. It's God telling us, hey, listen up, this is what you sort of need to do right now. Be anxious about nothing. It's more than that, though, isn't it? It's sort of saying, actually, but in everything, by prayer, you know, it's that conversation with God. It's choosing to take time to pray and seek God, to worship him. In isolation, you've got loads of time to be doing that right now. And supplication with thanksgiving, you know, choosing to thank God even in the midst of the storm. You know, with all this sort of stuff going on, with the news saying all sorts of things, media hyping stuff, friends saying different things, etc. You know, it says, let your requests be known to God. You know, you tell God, you know, how you're feeling. Pray to him, ask him, hey God, I'm really wrestling with this actually. God, I'm struggling with that. And or I've seen my mum stressing out a bit more about that, or whatever it is for you at home, you know, that you've sort of picked up on. You know, I encourage you guys, honestly, lay your heart open before Jesus with all this sort of stuff. In Mark 4, verses 35 to 41 as well, we just see Jesus calming the storm. And this is what I want to leave you guys with. You know, I'll just read it out to you quickly. It says, that day when evening came, Jesus said to his disciples, let us go over to the other side. So Jesus knew where he was going and where he was taking them right from the off, okay? Then it says, leaving the crowd behind. So they left everyone behind, a bit like us, sort of like leaving school behind for a little while, leaving friends behind for a little while. You know, they took him along just as he was in the boat. Okay, they've stepped out, they've gone with Jesus, they're trusting Jesus. Okay, there were also other boats with him. A furious squall came up, and the waves broke over the boat so that it was nearly swamped. Okay, this is like people getting shipwrecked. This is like SOS, ship going down sort of thing. You know, they're assuming the worst possible natural disaster that they've known, you know, happening to them. You know, but Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. I love that. Jesus is just napping in the storm. You know, for some of you, you might feel this is your ultimate calling in life. Actually, God has called me to sleep for 14 hours a day and play PlayStation for 10 or something like that. Yeah, but in this situation, in this crazy time, okay, we see Jesus sleeping in the storm. I love this passage, I really do. You know, the disciples, you know, they're freaking out. They're having like disciple moments, which we all have sometimes, okay? You know, and they go and they wake him up and they say, teacher, teacher, don't let us drown. Don't you care? You know, that's their heart cry on this, you know. And he got up and he rebuked the wind and said to the waves, quiet, be still. Then the wind died down and it was completely calm. You know, this is why we want to be praying, guys, praying that God speaks into this coronavirus situation. You know, because when God speaks, things happen. You know, God speaks, planets are created. When God speaks, storms are stilled. And we pray that God will speak into this and that coronavirus will be abolished. You know, in verse 40 he says, he said to his disciples, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith?" You know, in verse 41 it says, "They were terrified and asked each other, 'Who is this? Even the wind and waves obey him.'" You know, I think for me, if that was me on that boat, I think that would be the point when I'd sort of recognise and realise, wow, actually, maybe Jesus is Lord. Maybe Jesus is who he sort of says he is after all. You know, it's one of those things. Guys, it's really important for us all to remember that in this time of crisis, with so much things changing, rhythms of life switching up, you know, we need to wisely adapt to the changes in life. You know, we might be out of our routines a little bit, okay, but let's be wise and let's not let that sort of thing rock us too much, so to say. You know, we get to stand on the promises of God in this time, don't we? We get to look to him, look to the heaven for help, so to say. You know, we know that Jesus loves us, you know, despite anything we've ever thought, said or done that's wrong. You know, anything, even this week, you know, things that we might have done and we know maybe we shouldn't have done that actually. You know, God sees that, and we need to remember that he's paid a price for that. He's paid a price for our sin when he went to the cross for us. You know, that we now get to call on him for mercy and for grace in this time.